Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, class. Today we are going to talk about the 9th meeting of our course. Yeah. So we are going to talk about meeting 9. It's talking about class activity. Yeah. So here, there are some important points that you have to understand if you talk about the last activity. Yeah, the last activity here means everything that you have done in the past time. Yeah, so when you want to make a sentence by using past activity, you have to consider about the use of form in sentence. It is called as simple past tense. Nah, jadi apapun itu bentuk kegiatan di masa lampau, kita harus membuat form sentence-nya dalam bentuk simple past tense. Nah, di dalam slide ini, ya, here there are many example of the use of simple past tense. Ya. Banyak sekali contohnya penggunaan simple past tense. But I would like to share you about the simple or the easy one, how to understand about the use of simple past tense. Nah, sekarang I would like to explain to you how to make and how to construct a simple, the use of simple past tense. Okay, here, how to use a simple past tense. Well, if we talk about simple past tense, ya, jika kita berbicara mengenai penggunaan simple past tense, kita nggak perlu menghafal yang namanya rumus. Kita nggak perlu yang menghafal namanya subject, tambah verb to, tambah object, bla 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 bla, no. Yang perlu ada dalam kepala itu adalah penggunaan simple past tense menggunakan verb kedua jika kalimat tersebut ada terdapat kata kerja, ya, verb kedua. Kemudian bagaimana kalau seandainya simple past tense itu tidak menggunakan atau tidak ada kata kerja di dalamnya, maka kita akan menggunakan yang namanya to be, ya. To be apa yang akan kita gunakan, yaitunya to be, was, atau were. Kalau dia tidak ada kata kerja di dalamnya. Nah, kata kerja itu apa contohnya? Nah, I have explained to you in the last meeting. Berjalan, menulis, membaca, menyanyi. Nah, kalau dalam penggunaan simple present, itu kita menggunakan verb one. Tapi kalau dalam menggunakan simple past tense, kita menggunakan yang namanya verb two. Nah, kata atau sentence yang di dalamnya terdapat kata kerja itu disebut dengan verbal sentence, ya. Misalnya, saya pergi ke kampus kemarin. Nah, apakah itu simple past tense? Ya, karena kejadiannya itu adalah in the past, sudah berlalu. Nah, so how can you make this sentence become English sentence? Nah, kalimat ini disebut dengan verbal sentence. Verbal sentence, ya. Yeah. So, how can you combine? How can you make this sentence become English? Saya pergi ke kampusnya kemarin. Nah, so, you have to make saya pergi. Pergi, verb one-nya adalah go. Verb two adanya when. I went, ya, to the campus yesterday. Ah, yesterday ini adalah penanda dari simple past tense. Kemudian, how can you make this sentence become negative one? Saya nggak pergi ke kampus kemarin. Nah, kalau dalam penggunaan simple present seperti yang udah kita bahas sebelumnya, itu penggunaannya kita harus menggunakan do atau does. Nah, dalam simple past tense, penggunaan do atau does itu tidak ada lagi karena kita akan menggunakan yang namanya did. Ya, kalau do dan does itu berbeda untuk subjeknya. Nah, dalam simple past tense, all of the subject use did. Semua subjek menggunakan did. Berarti saya tidak pergi ke kampus kemarin. Nah, apa bahasa Inggrisnya? I, ya, I did not. Nah, jangan lupa kita tambahkan not. Jadi semua subjek, mau itu si Shirley, mau itu si Bram, mau itu si John, itu tetap kita gunakan did. I didn't go to the campus yesterday. Nah, verb-nya akan kembali menjadi verb one. Look at here. Ya. Jadi yang menggunakan verb to hanyalah kalimat positif saja. I went to the campus yesterday. I didn't go to the campus yesterday. Nah, go-nya berubah menjadi verb one karena sudah ada kata did. Nah, did ini kan verb kedua dari do. Jadi kita nggak perlu menggunakan when lagi di sini. Nah, yang menggunakan verb kedua itu hanya kalimat positif saja karena di sini sudah ada kata did. Oke. Kemudian, how can we make this sentence become interrogative one? Cukup kita tarik yang namanya did itu ke depan. Did you go to the campus yesterday? Okay. Did you go to the campus yesterday? Yes, I did. No, I didn't. No, I didn't. Seperti itu jadinya. Oke. So, kalimat ini merupakan kalimat verbal karena ada kata kerja di dalamnya. Mana dia? Went. Oke. What do you say that in English? Melly membeli sayur-sayuran pagi ini. What do you call that in English? Melly bought a vegetable this morning. Okay, very good. Saya melihat dia kemarin. I saw him yesterday. Nah, melihat itu see, verb keduanya adalah saw. I saw him yesterday. Nah, how about negative sentence-nya? Saya tidak melihat dia kemarin. I didn't see. Kembali ke bentuk verb one-nya. I didn't see him yesterday. Nah, did you see him? Did you see him yesterday? Yes, I did. No, I didn't. Nah, so that is about how to use simple past tense in form of verbal sentence. Nah, bagaimana kalau seandainya ya tidak ada kata kerja di dalamnya? So it's called as a nominal sentence. Nominal sentence. Apa itu nominal sentence? Tidak ada kata kerja di dalamnya. Misalnya seperti yang pernah kita kasih contoh, for example, si Rudy adalah seorang anak yang pelit dulunya ketika dia kecil ya. Rudy adalah seorang anak yang pelit dulunya, dulu ya, sekarang enggak lagi. So, ada enggak kata kerja di dalamnya? Enggak ada ya. Pelit itu kan adjective. Misalnya, kamu adalah seorang mahasiswa yang rajin dulunya. You are a clever student, kalau itu dalam bentuk simple present. Nah, kalau misalnya dulunya, berarti to be or itu kita akan merubah menjadi were. Ya, jadi kalau dalam simple past tense, itu to be-nya adalah was dan were. Was dan were. Nah, dia adalah seorang anak yang rajin dulunya. What do you call that in English? So, use was atau were. She was a diligent student in the past. Okay, dulu ya dia rajin, sekarang lebih rajin lagi ya. Okay, good. So, how can you make it into negative one? Nah, kalau negative one, kita cukup tambahkan not setelah yang namanya kata bantu, setelah yang namanya to be, tinggal tambahkan not saja. So, what do you call that in English? She was not a diligent student. Okay. In the past. Okay. So, how can you make this sentence become interrogative one? Misalnya Anda bertanya ya, apakah dia seorang mahasiswa yang rajin dulunya? Saya heran nih, kok dia sekarang pemalas? Emangnya dia dulu seorang mahasiswa yang rajin? So, you can make it in was she a diligent student? Okay. In the past. Right. Jawabannya adalah yes, she was. No, she was not. Okay. No, she was not. Jadi ini kalau tidak ada kata kerja di dalamnya. Yang tidak ada kata kerja itu biasanya ada terdapat kata sifat. Rumahnya itu dulu bagus loh. His house was very good. His house was very good. His house was very big in the past. His house is very clean in the past. Jadi kita gunakan penggunaan was di sana karena nggak ada kata kerja. Tapi rumahnya sekarang itu udah kotor, nggak bersih lagi, ya nggak seperti dulu lagi. His house was not clean anymore. Okay. So was his house was his house cleaned in the past? Itu dia. Jadi nggak ada kata kerja di dalamnya. Yang ada adalah adjective. Nah, kalau tidak ada kata kerja di dalamnya, kita gunakan yang namanya to be. Sebenarnya penggunaan simple past tense itu mirip dengan simple present. Cuman bedanya ada di kata bantu dan juga ada di kata kerja. Jadi kita tidak perlu menghafal yang namanya rumus. Okay? Jadi poinnya adalah simple past tense. Kalau ada kata kerja, kita gunakan verb kedua. Ya, kalau tidak ada kata kerja, kita gunakan to be yang namanya was atau were. Okay. So, let's go back to the slide. Ya. Nah, kalau kita melihat slide ini, it's very very complicated, right? So, you have to understand about what I have give you example. Nah. Jadi ini nggak perlu dilihat dulu. Yang paling penting adalah apa yang Miss jelaskan tadi. Oke, okay, look at this one. Nah, kalau dia dalam kata kerja, dalam questions, nah, look at this example of conversation. So, what did you do last weekend, Meg? Apa yang kamu lakukan minggu lalu, Meg? Katanya. So, kita ada penggunaan did di sini. Did, kemudian verb-nya do. Ya, itu kembali ke verb awal. Jadi kalau udah ada kata did, itu verb temannya itu kembali ke verb awal. Ke verb pertama. Oh, I had a great time. Saya punya waktu yang sangat menyenangkan. Katanya have, sebenarnya di sini adalah have. Tapi karena dia past tense, kita menggunakan kata verb to. I went, ya, and sang. Itu asal katanya sing. Oke. Okay. Did you go? Did. Kemudian ini kembali ke verb one karena udah ada did. No, we didn't. We went to. Oke. Okay. Jadi itu dia penggunaan dalam bentuk conversations. Oke. Okay. Kemudian ada studied, ada forgot. Itu asal katanya forget, ya. Nah, here complete this conversation dan practice with the partner. Kalau dia dalam bentuk kata tanya seperti ini, berarti apa yang ada di depannya? Pasti kita bertanya antara menggunakan to be dengan menggunakan did, ya kan? Untuk simple past tense. Pertanyaannya ini kalimatnya verbal atau nominal? Nah, stay. Stay itu adalah kata kerja. Jadi kita menggunakan to be, bukan menggunakan yang namanya kita menggunakan yang namanya did, ya, karena dia adalah verbal, bukan menggunakan yang namanya to be. So, what do you call the how can you complete this question? Did you stay home on Saturday? Ya, yeah, did you stay home? Stay-nya verb pertama karena sudah ada did. No, I didn't call. I didn't call. Call-nya tetap karena udah ada did. I didn't call my friend. We blah 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 drive to a cafe for lunch. Drive ini berubah menjadi verb kedua nantinya. We drove to a cafe for lunch. Okay. Jadi seperti itu penggunaannya. Nah, ingat, that is the most important one if you want to make a sentence in form of simple past tense, ya. Itu dia kata kunci untuk simple past tense. Jadi nggak perlu menghafal rumus. Okay. Okay. Ini ada complete word power, ya, the improving your vocabulary. Okay, ada pet, hobbies, childhood, places, professions, ya. Silakan Anda gabungkan kata yang ada di sini ke dalam kelompoknya, ya. Mana yang termasuk pets di sini? Rabbit, kemudian ada apa lagi? Ada cat, ya, hobbies. Mana yang termasuk ke dalam hobbies di sini? Anda masukkan ke dalam kategorisnya, place, tempat, possessions, okay, ya. Yeah. So letter, you can make a sentence by using this group word ya. Okay, ini masih contoh dari simple past tense ya. I was pretty good actually. Nah, karena nggak ada kata kerja, digunakanlah was. I played chess when I was in elementary school. Nah, I played chess. Berarti di sini ada verb kedua. Oke. Okay. The next one, ya. Yeah. This is conversation. How was your vocation? Oke, okay, ini menanyakan tentang your experience in the past, ya. Yeah. How was your vocation? Last holiday. Kenapa kita pakai was di sini? Karena there is no verb ya. Yeah. How was your vacation? Bagaimana liburan kamu? Ya. Yeah. It was very exciting. It was a very it was very interesting. It was very nice because I went to abroad with my family. Ya. Yeah. So you can make a sentence using this one, yeah, because on vacation it is about your experience in the past. Okay, here there is also another question that can you make when you want to arrange a simple past tense. Yeah, here, where did you spend your last vacations? Kalau udah pakai did, berarti spend-nya harus verb one. How long were you away? Who were you with? What did you do there? How was the weather? How was the food? Do you want to go there again? Ini jenis pertanyaan yang bisa ditanyakan ketika you want to ask about the vacation of your friends in the past. Okay. Okay, the next one is we are going to talk about writing a postcard. Okay, it's about writing a postcard. Maybe this is a you can write this postcard and then write a postcard to the partner about your last vacation, then exchange postcard. Do you have any question about the vacation? Maybe this is like a letter, yeah, telling your experience, yeah, telling your experience in the past. For example, here Richard, Katie want to share experience with Richard about his vacation, yeah. So don't forget to use verb to and also was or where when you want to make a sentence. Okay. Okay, here another question that you can ask with your friend when you're talking about something in the past, yeah? What is your favorite childhood memory? Yeah, about your childhood memories. What kind of sport or games did you used to play when you were younger? Did you used to have a nickname? Ada nggak nama pendek atau nama panggilannya, nama panggilan kesayangannya ketika waktu kecil. Where did you used to spend your vacations? How has your taste in music changed? That's about the case. Okay, so it's about the use of simple past. Okay, let me try to discuss about this exercise. Yeah, number one. Where did you go on last holiday? I went to Taj Mahal in blah 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 on last holiday. Where is Taj Mahal? I'm sure that you know this answer. India, yeah. The second one is, hello Martin, where did you go on your free time? Hi John, I blah 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 go anywhere on my free time. Nah, perhatikan di sini ada verb one. Berarti kalau go berarti saya tidak pergi kemana-mana waktu senggang saya. I did it or did not? Did not, of course, ya. Yeah. I didn't go anywhere on my free time. Okay. And the next one is, how was your holiday, James? It was great. I blah 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 to friends with my family. Apa jawabnya? Ini sudah pasti went, ya. Yeah. Okay. Number four. Was each of the place good? Of course, there blah 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 a restaurant that has a very good food. Okay, there a restaurant. Okay, was each of place good? Of course, there was or there were. And the question is, there blah 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 a restaurant that has a very good food. Ada sebuah restoran yang makanannya lezat katanya. Berarti that was ya. Perhatikan di sini ada was berarti pasti ini bertanya menggunakan simple past tense. Okay, good. The last question is, okay, what did you do last Saturday? I just blah 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 at home and watch TV. I just, okay, berarti ini kan positive, yeah. This is positive sentence. So you have to make a verb too. Don't forget to use verb too. Ah, sudah pasti ini gampang sekali. Jawabannya adalah stayed, yeah. I just stayed at home and watch TV. Okay, that is about our lesson for this meeting. Okay, class. Yeah, I hope you understand about my explanation. Yeah, thank you for your attention. And assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Bye.